Hello everyone, welcome back to the Aspen Tech channel. So in our previous video, which was lecture number 94, we had discussed how to calculate Exergy using Aspen Plus and using MS Excel. Obviously, Exergy consists of two parts. One part was calculated from Aspen, while other part was calculated from Excel using mathematical formulas. So in today's video, we are extending and we are now using Aspen HYSYS for this. And in the previous video, which was lecture number 94, we had used only one component, which was water, and that calculations were relatively simple. But in this video, obviously we are taking more than one components and a bit complexity involved. In that case, in the previous video, we had used heat exchanger as example, while here we will be using compressor as an example. Just for a refresher, that exergy is an important concept. It is used to evaluate the performance of chemical processes, and it consists of four parts, obviously: physical exergy, chemical exergy, kinetic exergy, and potential exergy. But obviously, since the heights are not involved like in that of the flash separator, where gravitational roles are involved, these two exergies do not play any role. So kinetic and potential exergies are not included in the discussion, but physical and chemical exergies are included. And these are the formulas that physical exergy is calculated, and we will take this exergy from Aspen HYSYS in this lecture, and obviously we had taken it from Aspen Plus, but we will see that the physical exergy calculated from Aspen Plus procedure or interface is different from Aspen HYSYS. However, the values will obviously be the same if we are using the same reference conditions. Then chemical exergy is calculated, percentage exergy efficiency formula, and exergy destruction formula. So we have been given a compressor data. Stream data is temperature 25 degrees centigrade, pressure 1 atm, flow rate 100 kg mole per hour, and the composition is 79 mole percent nitrogen and 21 mole percent oxygen, and we have to compress it to a pressure of 5 bar. And if we talk about the specific formula for this, the percentage exergy efficiency will be calculated as output stream exergy divided by inlet stream exergy plus energy. This is one of the way to do it. Obviously, other formulas are available in literature, but obviously we will get almost the same answer from that. And exergy destruction in kilowatt is calculated as inlet minus outlet. Obviously, inlet is feed plus energy and outlet is product. So we will do the calculations, and before doing that, we will first calculate physical exergy from Aspen HYSYS. So let's quickly move to Aspen HYSYS and solve the process. So quickly, we will add two components, which are nitrogen and oxygen, and then we will add the fluid package, which is Peng-Robinson, which is applicable for this system. Going to simulation environment and selecting the compressor and doing the required connections. First, changing its name to compressor and feed air. Outlet is compressed air power produced, and as a result, the bar turns yellow. Now we have to specify the properties: 25 degrees centigrade, 1 atm, 100 kg mole per hour, and if you double click it, 0.79 for nitrogen and 0.21 for oxygen, and specifying outlet pressure as 5 bar. And this is how the compressor is solved. This is a very simple procedure to solve the compressor, but the real thing is that how we can specify the reference conditions. And obviously, for reference conditions, the procedure was very simple in Aspen Plus, and also it is simple in Aspen HYSYS as well. So clicking here and opening the show correlation manager. This one is clipboard, this one is unit, this one is simulation. So in simulation, clicking on this correlation manager and going to the standard, and in standard, scrolling down until you get mass exergy over here. And the reference temperature is 25 degrees centigrade, while reference pressure is 101.3 kilopascal. So obviously it is not equivalent to 1 atm, because for 1 atm it should be 101.325 kilopascal. So we will change it as 101.325 kilopascal. So it will be 25 degrees centigrade and 1 atm. So now we will come back here and we will double click on this compressor. We will open worksheet and going to the properties. And if you see in the properties, that mass exergy is given in kilojoule per kg. If you remember, in Aspen Plus, this exergy was in kilowatt, but here it is in kilojoule per kg. But obviously we can convert it to kilowatt by multiplying by mass flow rate and then converting from kilojoule per hour to kilojoule per second. So we have to copy paste these two exergies. These are the physical exergies. Again, these are not chemical exergies. We have to calculate chemical exergy from Excel sheet. So we will copy. Now what to copy? Obviously the mass exergy, which is in kilojoule per kg, going to the conditions, the mass flow rate, which will be required for conversion to the kilowatt of physical exergy, and we need mole flow rates and molar composition which will be required for the chemical exergy. So we have copy pasted all the data here in Excel sheet, and if you see exergy kilojoule per kg, flow rate kg per hour, and now we have to convert it to physical exergy of kilowatt. And how we can do it? We have to multiply exergy with flow rate, and it is currently in kilojoule per hour, divided by 3600 to convert it to kilojoule per second. And again, even copy pasting, and it is 157.23. So kilojoule per second gives us the answer of kilowatt. So this is how physical exergy is calculated. Now we have to calculate the chemical exergy part, and as we have seen before, there are two terms which are associated with it, and one of the term includes the standard chemical exergy. So we have to calculate the standard chemical exergy, or we have to take from literature these two values. So as you can see, the standard chemical exergy of nitrogen is 0.72 kilojoule per mole, while that of oxygen is 3.97 kilojoule per mole. So we have to now calculate the chemical exergy. And so for chemical exergy calculation, we will be first needing the mole flows and molar composition. That the flow rate is 100 kg mole per hour for both air streams. Mole fraction for nitrogen and oxygen remains the same in the process because it's simple compression, there is no separation. So 0.79 and 0.21 for both. Now we have to calculate the first term, the chemical exergy, term number one. We have to calculate it. How we can calculate it? That we have to multiply this flow rate with the mole fraction and with this kilojoule per mole. So for a single component, this was our procedure. And if you see, this is 56.88, but that is in currently kilo multiplied by kilojoule per hour. Obviously, we have to multiply it 1000 and divide by 3600, if you remember the previous lecture as well. However, this was for a single component, and for two components, what we need to do, there are different aspects as well. You can apply some product formula as well, but again, I'm keeping it simplified. So flow rate multiplied by the composition and multiply its relevant chemical exergy. So again, calculating it, and now you can multiply it with 1000 and divide by 3600. So converting it to number and making sure that once you drag it, the terms do not change. So applying or fixing this G cell as well. And now you can simply drag it. And obviously the chemical exergy for these two will remain the same. The term number one, because of the fact that there is no separation. These terms might change, or obviously definitely change when there is a change in composition, because XI factor is involved in the system. Now we will calculate the chemical exergy term number two. And how it is calculated, as if we see again, RT naught summation XI natural log of XI. So 8.314 multiplied by 298.15 multiplied by flow rate. If we take it like that, flow rate multiplied by the composition multiplied by natural log of composition. This closes the first term, then plus molar flow rate multiplied by the composition multiplied by the natural log of composition. So closing it down, and it has given answer in this. Obviously we have to divide that answer by 3600 to get answer in kilowatt, because all the units should be consistent in the system as well. And again dragging it, and the same answer for that term as well. So now we have to calculate the chemical exergy in kilowatt, and if you can see, chemical exergy in kilowatt, that is adding these two terms in the system. So that's how the chemical exergy is calculated for compression system, or for a stream of a compressor system as well. Now we have calculated physical exergy, we have calculated chemical exergy. We have to simply add these two exergies to get our required exergy value, which is total exergy in kilowatt. But again, make sure all these exergies are in same unit, because if these are not in the same unit, these will lead to incorrect answers. And obviously, the energy value is also important in the system. So if we take it like this and just dragging it like that, for feed air, the total exergy is 3.57 kilowatt. For compressed air, which is at the outlet of compressor, is 160.8 kilowatt, and energy required is 185.19 kilowatt. It's already in kilowatt, so there is no need to change it. Now we have to apply the formula, and the formula, I have told you that there are different formulas available in the literature. That percentage exergy efficiency is outlet air exergy minus inlet air exergy divided by the energy and multiplying by 100. So it gives answer in 84.9 as exergy efficiency. And exergy destruction, if we can calculate it, how it is calculated, like it is in percentage, and we have to calculate kilowatt, that is inlet. So what is in inlet? Feed air plus the energy minus compressed air. So 27.96 kilowatt of exergy is destructed in the process. while the exergy efficiency of the process is 84.9%. And then there is another formula to calculate the exergy efficiency, which I have shown in the slides, that compressed air, which is outlet divided by inlet. So that is another way of calculating the exergy efficiency. But you can see the exergy efficiency is slightly high for the second formula. Obviously, you cannot use the same nomenclature across each combination. So for compressor, the most widely used formula is that outlet air exergy minus inlet air exergy divided by the total work required multiplied by 100. However, the exergy destruction for both cases will remain the same because it is simply inlet minus outlet. So that's how exergy efficiency is calculated using Aspen HYSYS, that we have taken physical exergy, but again in a different fashion. Like in Aspen Plus, we got exergy directly in kilowatt. Here we have to convert it to kilowatt. Then we have taken two components, and again we have seen the overall procedure for both components as well, and then we have checked how exergy efficiency is calculated for a compression system. This was a slight complex example as compared to the heat exchanger because we have included two components, but again separation system is not involved, because once separation system is involved, the exergy values changes. As you can see, the term number 1 is same for both streams, 2 is same for both streams, and even chemical exergy same for both streams. But once separation system is included, this does not happen. So in the next video or in the upcoming videos, we will be discussing the separation system exergy efficiencies as well. So that's it from this lecture. Thank you so much. Please do watch, like, share the video and subscribe to the channel Aspen Tech. Also, please subscribe to my second channel, which is the Chemical Engineering channel. And I'm regularly uploading videos over there as well. Till then, it's goodbye. Stay tuned.